Welcome everybody to the Top Back Podcast, the show where we share our love of nerd culture for your entertainment. I'm one of your hosts, Matt.
And I'm Mike.
And today we're going to talk about more episodes of WandaVision on Disney Plus, episodes 3 and 4. So Mike, all right, I'm going to start off with this saying that I think episodes 3 and 4 are a vast improvement over the first two.
Yes.
I'm not saying that just because it's in color.
And speaking of color, now we have titles of like the episodes. Yeah.
So what are the episodes called, Mike?
The third episode is Now in Color. And then the fourth episode is We Interrupt This Program.
Okay.
So it's like, again, everything's like meta. Mm-hmm. So it's three was like a good, you got me, okay, where are we going?
Yeah.
And then four was like, I'm into it.
Right. All right. So episode three, Now in Color. So they shifted to a 70s era of television.
Brady Bunch.
Honestly, I can't tell the difference. I feel like these shows should have different vibes.
Mm-hmm. Vibes. The vibes.
Vibes. I didn't feel the difference really like I should have.
From like the, you know, episode, I mean, 1 and 2?
Yeah, I don't know why. It still feels like the same. I can't really explain it.
Just like the pacing, you think?
Yeah, the pacing's the same. Yeah. The jokes are still the same.
Because of the laugh track.
Yeah, it's the laugh track. I don't know. But anyway.
Like, you couldn't really tell the difference.
If it wasn't in color yet.
If it wasn't in color.
Black and white again, it'll still be the same kind of show. But I like the fact that it was in color. I could see everything. I can enjoy the visuals a lot more, for sure.
Elizabeth Olsen is radiant. Yeah. She's glowing.
This is my favorite episode of her so far.
She's bae. Dude, all her facial expressions on this episode, clearly.
I know.
She's beautiful.
We're going to suck on her a lot throughout the whole series. But yeah, so this episode was a big improvement, in my opinion, because we got a little bit more tension between her and Vision. You start to feel what's happening.
Mm-hmm.
Before I even watch episode 4, I caught on what was going on. So mm-hmm. she's creating this world of television, and she picks and chooses what she wants to happen in this world.
Exactly.
So
she's the director of it all.
Yeah. But what I don't understand is why she keeps changing eras of television. Like, so what's the timeline in this?
So I think, so people are saying, like, since Wanda grew up in Sokovia, and like the sitcoms are what she grew up on,
mm-hmm.
like learning about American culture, like either her or her family like grew up on those sitcoms. Yeah. So I think it's just her trying to, I don't know. That's a great question. Like, why is it specifically sitcoms? I don't know. Maybe just Kevin Feige just wants to be all cute with it.
That's where I got a little annoyed when I start to really think about it. It's like, mm-hmm. it really is gimmicky, mm-hmm. the way he's doing the show, because if it's just one air per episode, it's mm-hmm. like, what's the point of mm-hmm. even doing that if it doesn't have a purpose? Because
mm-hmm.
when we started with the 50s, I get the whole, like,
God,
she wants this old world where everything's like very, mm-hmm. there's no technology. It's really like home.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Family-oriented. Yeah. Family life. Yeah. And that's what she... Well, she lost her family.
Mm-hmm.
Pietro died. Her family died. And then Vision, ultimately her husband, mm-hmm. like... and then eventually in the next episodes, or this end of this episode, she mm-hmm. has kids. So I think the sitcoms are just her way of like manifesting mm-hmm. like this reality that everything's all good, and when she's really grieving,
right.
and it's not.
Right. But like I said, it's like, what is the point of going through different eras?
True.
You know what I mean? It's like you're yearning for the simple life, mm-hmm. but as you keep going, you keep progressing through the eras, it's just mm-hmm. going to get more complicated. You're making it more complicated.
Yeah.
So, and the timeline doesn't make sense, because in this episode, she has babies
mm-hmm.
and they happen within
everything's
12 hours. Yeah.
Yeah.
So what is the whole point of this?
I don't know. Yeah. Kevin Feige is just like, I can do what the fuck I want now.
I'm gonna explain later why this is starting to annoy me, even though I do love the show. It's getting better. It's mm-hmm. getting a lot better. But with this whole gimmick of TV shows, it's starting to show why this show is not hitting like it's supposed to, like I wanted it to. Yeah.
So you're speaking on the way...
If I'm thinking too hard about it.
Yeah. If you're looking at it from the lens of that it's a show,
mm-hmm.
but when you're looking at it as a fan of like everything, mm-hmm. MCU-wise, I think that's where the entertainment value is.
Yeah, it's entertaining for sure.
It doesn't... That entertainment doesn't hit till end of episode 3 at mm-hmm. beginning of episode 4.
Right.
I did love the appearance of Wanda and Vision when they were like both side to side. Mm-hmm. That's like a comic book reference there.
That was it.
Yeah, so everything is, again, Elizabeth Olsen is radiant in here, pregnant-wise, and the whole series is, they kept talking about like for the children mm-hmm. in episode 2, and now episode 3, she's pregnant, and like it's a sped-up pregnancy, mm-hmm. and how Geraldine is like the neighbor that comes in,
right?
And we all suspect that she's Monica Rambeau. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of comic book references there because mm-hmm. her mom's nickname is Photon, and yeah, then her comic book character Monica Rambeau becomes Photon.
Yeah,
and then like,
and then she also becomes Captain Marvel.
Yeah, in other iterations. Mm-hmm. So everything is like Captain Marvel related here.
Yeah, I had no idea.
And then the next episode, they're like, there's even more ties to everything Marvel. Mm-hmm. So I think probably just the best part of episode 3 was
the interaction.
The interaction, like you feel like, okay, she's a best friend to Wanda, but also like Monica's character was kind of like a stereotypical of like, well, how black people were preserved in sitcoms. The fro and the foxy.
Yeah.
So
the lingo.
So I noticed that. I don't know if other people noticed it too.
Yeah. But I mean, if it's the 70s, you have to include. That's what I'm talking about. You have to make these eras feel different. Mm-hmm. That is a good way to do it. If mm-hmm. the language they speak is different too.
That's true.
So.
And she was looking.
She's bomb. Beautiful.
She's
too.
So beautiful.
What's her name again?
I forget her actress name, but
yeah.
Melanin. Crushing on her. Crushing on everyone on this show. Crushing on Paul Bettany.
Okay. I love Paul Bettany too, though.
And so, people noticed that Vision, like when he tried to get the doctor, mm-hmm. he was running super fast.
Yeah.
And that's not necessarily Vision's
right.
superpower. Right. So there's other theories of like how Vision is like another comic book character, like his body, but Vision's consciousness. But we can get into that way
I
later.
Thought you were going to talk about he just gave him her brother.
Pietro's power. Yeah, okay, yeah, so that's one thing. And then when the twins are born, so like the whole debate of like what name should they be, mm-hmm. and then it turns out to be like Thomas and William, mm-hmm. and then like that's pretty cool nod, like okay, these kids are coming, they're coming to life literally. Yeah. And then the moment when Monica talks about Ultron, mm-hmm. and I was like, bitch, don't say that word.
Yeah.
And I just found out a week ago Ultron is Robert California in The Office.
Not really,
that's him, bro. No wonder I fucking hate
him. No wonder I didn't like him. I
fucking
either.
Hate Robert California. And like
that's crazy.
But and then Ultron, that like makes Wanda like trip, and so she was like, Wanda was so cute in the episode, and then she starts snapping. She's like, what did you say? And this bitch went crazy.
That's always my favorite parts of these three episodes, is when it doesn't stick to the sitcom mode anymore. Mm-hmm. It goes into like the reality.
Yeah,
it switches back and forth. But this time specifically, when you said Monica mentioned Ultron, that whole shift, I was like, I got really invested for like, what's gonna happen? What's she gonna do?
The shit was tense.
Yeah,
right?
It was really tense. And then she started to use her powers, which we haven't seen this whole show yet. Mm-hmm. Like she was using the Bewitch powers, but this mm-hmm. is her actual powers. Mm-hmm. And then you know all that stuff happens.
And then like the way the show was cut, mm-hmm. it's like Vision comes in like, where's Geraldine? Oh, she had to leave.
Right.
And I was like, did you kill her? Right. Like, what the fuck? And then they're holding the babies, and then end of the episode. And then end of episode 3, we see Monica thrown out of the whole reality. Mm-hmm. And then you see Sword. And I was like, at first, at the end, I was like, okay, is Sword monitored? Like, why is Sword outside? Mm-hmm. And then episode 4 explains everything.
Yeah. I had a theory, too, when I watched the end of the episode. Because remember when Tony had his invention in a... was it, what movie was that, Civil War?
Yeah,
he had barf, right?
Yeah.
I thought that's what she was using, or exactly. like an iteration of that, because it had the holographic like thing hovering over it. I was like, what the fuck is he doing? Mm-hmm. And then once we get to the next episode, it is Wanda. Mm-hmm. But I'm wondering how she's projecting all this and how she's doing it. So
it's an actual town, we find out
in the next episode. So it's going to be interesting to see what shifted her to do this in the first place, because mm-hmm. throughout that whole Endgame, mm-hmm. and between this and Endgame, we don't know what the hell she's been doing.
Yeah,
so that's what I'm interested to see in the next episode.
Yes,
for sure.
So all right, now we get into episode 4.
We interrupt this program.
So the episode starts off with Monica in a hospital. I thought it was a
dope ass.
That was probably one of the best openings in Marvel I've ever seen. Yeah. Just because, like,
it was so tense.
I thought it was after she got knocked out from the thing, but it was like she came back in the. Dude, I thought it was a movie.
Me too. That's what I'm saying.
Like, damn, they went back to like 2021 visuals, mm-hmm. and like everybody blipping back, right. and then the tension in the scene.
I like how we're using that term too, because I thought it was just a joke. Yeah. Far From Home. Yeah. Because the teenagers made that term, right? Mm-hmm. So I found it a little weird that they used that term too, yeah. when they blipped or whatever. But like you said in the beginning of the episode, I like the fact that everyone was in a panic because. Mm-hmm. In Far From Home, they made it seem like a joke.
Yeah.
But in my mind, I was like, if everyone came back exactly how they were,
yeah.
that's going to be kind of weird. Because what about the people who are in airplanes?
Yeah.
They're going to end up in the air.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck's going to happen?
Like, Peter's mom, Aunt May talked about she showed up in someone's home.
Yeah.
And this scene really shows the hecticness of, like, anywhere. Like, yeah. And then, since we're in 2021, I was like, oh, shit, COVID. Like, this is how ICUs look like at capacity.
Exactly.
Like,
right.
People are panicking. And we find out that her mom passed away 3 years prior.
Yeah.
2 years after the Endgame started. Or 2 years after, like, the whole vanishing.
Mm-hmm.
And, like. Yeah, just seeing through Monica's eyes of holy shit, what the fuck happened?
Yeah.
It's and then a couple of weeks later, she goes back to Sword.
Yeah.
And Sword, like Sword, is a subdivision of Shield. There's
is it a subdivision or completely different?
It's just like another branch of it. Yeah. I saw people were like, "Where was Sword this whole time when other Avengers shit was happening? Where did Sword like?" Did Sword just start? Did they get new funding?
Right. Well, they said that Monica. Mm-hmm. Was it Monica?
Her mom.
Her mom was Monica.
Her mom.
Maria Rambo. She started it.
Yeah. Yeah.
So obviously after Captain 90, Marvel stuff,
90s.
She witnessed all of the alien activities. So she's like she has some knowledge of it. Yeah. So I'm pretty sure she teamed up with Shield or whoever.
Nick Fury.
Yeah, Nick Fury, and they created this whole thing on the down low. So this is like Area 51.
Yeah. Exactly. But it's a pretty big.
I know you can't miss it.
How the fuck you missed that?
Yeah, area? But like you said, when the whole Avengers shit started, where the fuck was Sword?
Yeah,
why was Nick using Sword instead of Shield?
Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, I just got that Sword and Shield.
Are you serious? I just got that.
What is it, Pokemon? Yes.
You serious?
I just got that.
Yeah.
Huh.
But yeah, but whatever. Let's just pretend all this existed before. Yeah, so she created this whole sword. I forgot what it stands for. And then she wants to get back into the whole thing after she came back. Mm-hmm. So,
but her mom grounded her wings.
Yeah. So.
Damn it, mom.
Yeah. And I, you know me, I wasn't the biggest fan of Captain Marvel. So
same. That was my favorite movie to watch on the airplane on the way to Captain South Africa. Because I was going to fall asleep.
Yeah. Even though that movie was really average, like I like the fact that they made it relevant. So that's a good thing about Kevin Feige. Even the terrible shit, he can still make it kind of, which kind of goes to this whole episode. He brought back a lot of D-list characters. So
Sure.
He brought Thor, Darkworld.
Darcy.
Yeah, Darcy. He brought Ant-Man from Randall.
Jimmy Woo.
Yeah.
Is it Jimmy Woo?
I forgot his name already. He's in
Fresh Off the Boat. Oh, you mean Jim Halpert?
yeah
Asian Jim.
Yeah, so he's bringing all these B or D list characters back and making them relevant, which
yes,
is cool.
Yes, I
appreciate that about Kevin Feige.
And this episode was way more like more serious, but like these D list characters were like the comic relief versus in the other episodes where you were forced because of the crowd,
right,
the laugh tracks or whatever, the audience. So that was a good nod there.
Yeah. What'd you think about Darcy and Agent Wu?
I think Darcy, like, so she was in that truck. I always, her character is the same everywhere, like in Two Broke Girls, in 40
Kat Dennings in general.
You mean? Yeah, 40-year-old virgin.
That's my favorite role, though.
Yeah. But for her, I just thought it was weird. I was like, now she has a PhD. I didn't, in the Thor movies, I didn't think of her as smart. I just thought she was like the intern, the only intern they could afford.
Yeah.
I thought Natalie Portman was going to make an appearance.
Yeah.
But,
but I like that though. It made her,
It rebooted her character.
Yeah, it rebooted her character. It makes sense. If she was an intern for her, obviously she would learn from Natalie Portman, wherever the hell she is.
And then she did mention how, like, the radiation or the CMBR that she...
Yeah, the cosmic whatever
cosmic stuff. Mm-hmm. So that stuff, like from the Big Bang,
yeah,
that happened, and so that's relevant because the Infinity Stones were created in the Big Bang.
Yeah,
so it's going back, like, so it's making this. Wanda's powers is really coming from the stones, and it's another dimension within mm-hmm. this whole thing. So Darcy explaining that, I was like, okay, I like your character yeah. now. And then her and Jim Halpert, yeah. Asian Jim, were like talking. It's like, you want some? And it's like, yeah, I kind of want kids someday. No, chips.
I like Randall Park, yeah. But I thought his character was a little annoying in this episode. Yeah, the dad jokes were getting a little annoying after a while.
That's just Randall Park. But
he was funnier in Ant-Man than the Wasp to me. Yeah, with this one, he was just a little more hammy than usual. Mm-hmm. But whatever, it's cool. I like the fact that they brought him back. Mm, yeah. Asian
representation. Thank you, Disney. But if it was, it has to be Randall Park. Randall Park's great.
Okay, so here's where... I want to get into this first.
Yeah.
The fact we knew from the very beginning that this whole shit was fabricated, that Wanda created this world and people were watching, because at the end of each episode we saw like television broadcasts. So I like the fact that they tied in what the events, like the weird events that are happening in her world.
Yeah.
They finally showed what was happening from the world perspective. So mm-hmm. like the beekeeper mm-hmm. from episode 2.
Who was a guy that was trying to get in.
Yeah.
And how when he went through that Stranger Things portal,
he
became something different.
Yeah.
And then the rope was a jump rope.
Jump rope, like an old school jump rope.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then again, episode 2, Randall was trying to communicate with her through mm-hmm. the radio.
Mm-hmm.
And then we finally see what that whole drone. Mm-hmm. I was right, that was a drone.
Yeah, you're right.
So we saw what that was. So all these things that she finds a little odd,
mm-hmm.
like these modern things, she's immediately like
resetting
it and putting it back to where it came from.
Yeah.
Although I don't know what happened to the dude.
The beekeeper. Yeah. Some people are saying like he might be the ice cream guy in the episode 3, but I don't know.
Okay.
That could be. And there's actually a comic book character like named Swarm, like with bees all over. So I don't know if he's going to be something else, but
I hope everyone's not a character. Like,
yeah.
Sometimes just be a character, but don't be like a significant hero or whatever.
Missing person, beekeeper. Yeah, where are you at?
I know.
Yeah,
but I like that they tied in perfectly to what we were kind of expecting already, but they mm-hmm. really showed how relevant it was.
Mm-hmm.
But, okay, this is where the TV shit annoyed me. Mm-hmm. When they're watching the shows that she's creating, I don't like that they made it really like a TV show from their perspective. It's like, is Wanda really creating these shows for people to watch, or is it just for her?
Yeah.
Because that's where it gets a little annoying. Like, what are you doing exactly? Mm-hmm. So you want people to watch this, or are you just doing this?
That's true.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Because they were watching a show, mm-hmm. and the show ending credits. I'm like, mm-hmm. you have time to do that in your head?
Very detailed one.
Yeah, I know. You have a whole cast and everything. I'm like, that's kind of stupid. Like, I wish they didn't include that part.
Yeah. But this is like the plot holes of like looking at it and it's super in-depth.
Yeah.
And then speaking of plot holes, not plot holes, but like the fact that it's a TV show. So it's a TV show that Sword is watching,
mm-hmm.
and we're watching this,
right?
So it's like so many different layers, like
three brick walls or fourth walls.
Like, who's watching us?
Yeah.
And like, well, Ryan Reynolds is like what was like fourth wall within a fourth wall. That's like
16 walls. It's great though. God. But yeah, it annoyed me. I didn't like that. I like they don't have to go too far when to explain that kind of stuff.
Yeah. I'm like, get me a TV. I'm like,
yeah.
You got that old TV? Is there or like Radio Shack nearby?
Right. And another thing too, I wish they showed like, I don't know, outtakes or like other episodes. Because they're just watching the same episodes we watch.
Yeah.
There has to have been more shit
in
between that. They could have shown like other scenes or something like that, like to make it more convincing.
Give us a season of
the 50s. Because the way Darcy was talking, it made it seem like they were watching so many episodes.
Mm.
So,
but they were like 30 focusing minutes
on
each.
Exactly, they're just focusing on the 2 episodes or 3 episodes we watched.
Yeah,
but they made it seem like they were watching for like weeks,
24 hours.
Yeah,
yeah.
So I wish they went a little more in detail.
True,
put a little more effort into that part.
And then the characters in episode 3 were tripping out. They were like, "What is Geraldine in there?" Mm-hmm. So we find out that Geraldine like got in there on her own, mm-hmm. and she was like trying to play a part,
mm-hmm.
like trying to investigate what's going on.
Yeah.
And then I like Randall Park's character, or mm-hmm. Jim Halpert, because he on the board, mm-hmm. the whiteboard, they put like questions of mm-hmm. like, is Vision alive, or like what's with the hexagons.
Right.
So the theories on that board is the theories that all YouTubers are putting out there too. Mm-hmm. So I was like, oh shit, this is really meta. Yeah. Like, this is, they knew that that's what we're thinking. Yeah.
This whole show is just Easter eggs. Mm-hmm. It's basically Easter eggs. I mean, all the Marvel movies before that were, mm-hmm. but I feel like this show specifically, it was made for us to pick apart and like really dive in to pick out all the details.
Yeah.
Which is cool. It's fun. But at the same time, it's like, it's distracting because I kind of just want to enjoy the show for what it is.
True.
And not focus too much on like trying to find Easter eggs or what does this mean? What does that mean?
Versus the movies, like you had to watch it in this of the story. But now this one, since it's a series, you're looking for the little things.
Right, right, right.
I enjoyed it. I liked it.
This is definitely my favorite episode. It was more intense than the other ones for sure. Mm-hmm. Only because we got out of the whole sitcom.
Yeah, finally.
I know. It goes back to what I said from our other review. I wish these were more like episode 3 and 4 could have easily been one episode because they tie in so well with each other. Same thing with episode 1 and 2. Mm-hmm. That's why the whole week to week bi thing. Mm-hmm. I just wish we could have binged this, honestly.
Yeah.
Or bi-weekly. Bi-weekly, or give us bigger chunks, because these 20-minute episodes is not enough for me.
Yeah, and with the 10-minute credits.
Yeah, right. I know. The credits they're just as long as the episodes sometimes. Yeah.
And this one didn't have a commercial or anything. It was just, it's a commercial within the commercial.
Yeah, yeah.
And probably as we're investigating more into the show, so looking more at Agnes's character, I got a lisp there. So like, Agnes is Agatha Harkness in the comics. And so so you talked about it earlier episode for us, that like, oh, she has to be more of a relevant character. So looking at her comic history, she was actually associated with like the Fantastic Four.
Really?
Yeah. The director mentioned like, oh, we have some astronauts that are missing because of the blip, and so this would be a cool nod at Fantastic Four. So then Silver Surfer is also associated with that stuff.
Yeah.
And then Agatha, like she's Wanda's mentor.
In the comics.
So it begs the question. Yeah, she's a witch. So and she dresses up as a witch in the later episodes when they do the Halloween thing.
Right.
And so is Agnes helping, because she's giving Wanda all those ideas of like making the children.
Right.
And in the comics, Mephisto, like the devil basically in the Marvel universe, who also gives Ghost Rider the power. Mm-hmm. So like, again, there's more stuff there. And so is Agnes working for Mephisto? Like, because Mephisto helps Wanda like get kids, and there's demon souls in those kids. So it's like all this thing about like Wanda having kids out of nowhere. Like, that's directly from the comics.
Right.
So it's like, is Agnes helping Wanda? Mm-hmm. Like, because she doesn't want Wanda to realize that this is not the reality that she is. Right, and then, you know, Dottie, the lady leader of that club, the blonde lady or whatever.
Episode 2.
Yeah. So it's like, she said the devil's in the details. So she could be Mephisto, like, pulling all the strings.
Interesting.
So
interesting.
Like, if you, and then you see Agnes saying like, oh, that's not where the devil is always also.
So you think this isn't actually Wanda herself creating it, it's actually other people.
It's Mephisto. It has to be Mephisto, just like, because he's another big baddie in the Marvel universe.
Right.
After looking it up. Thank you, YouTubers. Mm-hmm. Just because, and then like they're saying he's so higher up in power that you need someone like Doctor Strange to counter him. So he could be this phase's power. And then he's also, he has like a big fight with Doctor Doom. I'm just regurgitating everything I've like seen and read the last few days. So I'm like, damn, this would be pretty sick if this comes alive.
Okay. That makes it interesting then.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is a good setup for a lot of things.
Because like Misery Needs Company, that whole thing. Wanda's grieving from Vision's death. Mm-hmm. Oh shit. And that's probably like the craziest part. When we see Vision like turn around
it was dead Vision.
Yeah.
Stone ripped out of his head Vision.
Yeah.
That tripped me out.
That head ain't indestructible, Wanda. I was like, oh shit. And I watched this morning at like 7 a.m. I was like, I'm not ready for this, man. That was like Walking Dead kind of shit.
Yeah. So the whole twin thing though is shit. Okay, we obviously know Vision is not alive or whatever, so she can't get banged up by anybody.
Yeah.
So is she able to create things
herself? She can create things, yeah. If she can create a reality, why can't she create things
like
too?
Like life?
She can create life, essentially.
She just gave herself twins?
Yeah. Because, like, that's the doctor said, like, it was one kid. Mm-hmm. But And then Wanda and Vision were debating about names.
Yeah.
So it could be like Wanda created two kids subconsciously to satisfy both her and Vision's thing.
I see. So do you think Vision's actually dead?
I think Vision's dead. Paul Bettany said in an interview that there was an end credit scene where Wanda like got Vision's body bag or some shit.
Mm.
But that's pretty fucking creepy if you think about it.
Because if she could create life, I'm pretty sure she could just resurrect Vision somehow, right?
Yeah, but that's not really. Yeah, like fully, resurrecting fully.
Yeah.
I don't expect Vision to come out of this whole series alive.
Okay. That sucks.
Yeah. So like, it would be kind of stupid to bring back Vision for the rest of the series.
Yeah, yeah. But I mean, I wouldn't mind it anymore.
Yeah. If he's back alive or not.
I
wasn't clamoring for him to be back.
Me neither. I don't really care about Vision that long. But I like Paul Bettany though.
Yeah, me too.
He's a good Vision. Yeah. That's interesting though.
Yeah.
This is just a setup for the whole new phase, whole show.
It is.
If from what you're saying.
Yeah, what I'm from hearing everybody. And if I get shit wrong, please let me know. I'm not a comic book expert. I'm just learning as we go.
Yeah. It's interesting though. I like it.
Yeah.
I like it. But damn. This is 9 episodes, right?
9 episodes, so we're 5 more episodes to go.
Yeah.
I hope the next episodes, like, it's not just straight sitcom. It has to have that balance between sitcom
and I enjoy sword. It far more when it's more serious.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I wanted.
Mm. Like, shit that's happening in a sitcom.
Yeah.
The sword is, like, acting on it. We don't have to wait 3 more episodes to see what sword saw.
It's funny that you mentioned Big Bang, because I wonder if they're going to... If that's how they're going to end it with the sitcom.
What do you mean?
Then with the Big Bang Theory.
Have that kind of bullshit.
Yeah, I mean, because it works, because that's a very nerdy comic book show.
True, true.
And that's like the last real...
Track sitcom.
That actually succeeded.
Yeah. Of this last decade.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Right. Nah, and that was 2000s too. So if you have the full... I'm guessing it's going to be Full House when they reach the 90s.
Yeah.
So with 2000s, they can end with Big Bang Theory.
Mm. Oh yeah,
yeah.
Maybe throw in some Boy Meets World in there. Fresh Prince, Fresh Vision is the Fresh Prince. Oh my god,
that'd be terrible.
And Westview.
That'd be terrible.
You notice how Westview is like a W and a V, and a V.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, man, you guys are so observant.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that too. Every character or every person in this town plays a character
exactly
in Wanda's show.
Mm. But there's
like, go ahead. Oh, okay. And there's like 3,000 people from what they said in this town.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
And went from a missing person to a missing talent.
Talent, yeah.
And if you see the board, Agnes doesn't have an ID.
Oh.
Yeah. And then Dottie is not there. She's not on that board.
Oh.
So like,
or maybe they just didn't find her yet.
True. That's the thing, too. But I think Dottie, she's like, it could be a red herring, too.
Uh-huh.
But I think Dottie might be Mephisto.
Shit. I might do research on that. That's pretty cool.
So thank you to all you people on Instagram and YouTube telling us about these names. Mm-hmm. We have to look into it more.
Right.
But I'm so excited. Like, if Doctor Doom, Fantastic Four, all these shows, I'm juiced for it.
Yeah, Kevin Feige's smart. I think he knows what he's doing with this show.
He's a goat right now, bro.
I know. But for future shows, I would want them to be longer than this per episode. I think it would benefit more if they're like 45-minute episodes instead of just 20-25. Because it's really too short for me, honestly. Mm-hmm. Like, it's good at catching me in and like making me invested, but at the same time it's like I want more.
Yeah And then if we have 5 more weeks of this, I mean, I could have been fine with this show being like a month long instead of being 2 months.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
like give us 6 45 minute episodes. I think that would have been better.
Yeah,
that would be much better. Yeah, I'm excited though.
Yeah
This is definitely my favorite episode so far.
Mm-hmm.
For sure.
Elizabeth Olsen is bae.
Yeah.
The actress that plays Monica Rambeau is bae. All
right. Before this episode goes up, what do you think the 80s is going to reference?
I'm not too familiar. I'm forgetting 80s.
Did you
Full
watch
House
it?
Was the 80s, is it? No?
Technically. Or
90? Like,
technically.
I forget.
Because it was like 88, 89.
I know Three's Company was in the
70s.
The 70s.
So the next couple episodes, I'm predicting it's going to be just 2 or 3 more episodes of the sitcom stuff. Mm-hmm. And then it's going to go full throttle after that.
Bruh, you know it leaked? The next episode leaked.
It did already?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
It's on YouTube already.
You want to talk about that then?
No, okay. I don't want to say it. I don't want to.
Did you look into it? Or
no, I didn't look into it.
Okay.
I mean, I pressed 5 seconds. Oh, the promo. The promo's out.
Oh,
the promo's out.
Okay.
And then the person that leaked it, I guess, he's going to be in big ass trouble.
Mm-hmm.
So there, maybe next week, it might be 2 episodes. We'll see. That'd be kind of cool.
That would be cool.
That'd be cool.
See, I would love that.
I'll be like, sign me up.
I'm down.
Get your popcorn ready. And
that'd be good.
If what those thumbnails say on those leaks,
they're making me want to look at it now.
I know. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Shit. You're gonna fuck yourself up. Don't do it.
I might do it.
Don't do it.
I might do it.
No, bro. Because you just need more. Yeah. We need more.
My God. I'm excited though. So WandaVision, episode 3 and 4, fantastic. It's getting better and better, which is all I wanted from this show. Mm-hmm. And I just hope it keeps getting better from this point on. We have 5 more episodes to go. And then, yeah, it's going to be done.
Super Bowl weekend, we're probably going to get an Eternals trailer or a Shang-Chi trailer.
Right. Are you excited about Eternals, though?
Yeah, I mean,
I really don't care.
It's a big cast. I mean, it's going to play on the cosmic world, and Thanos is going to be in it.
Yeah, or more cosmic references.
More cosmic stuff. So
this might actually lead into Eternals then.
Yeah.
Somehow.
I don't know. We're like, people weren't excited with Guardians at first.
That's true.
Probably the best debut.
Yeah, because I haven't heard anything about Eternals, like not even leaks or story.
I've seen sets.
You've seen sets?
Like, and then seen the actors get all like ripped up. But I don't know. It'll be interesting. My Marvel hype is getting there now.
It's getting up again.
Back when like the Endgame, Infinity War games, because we had such a long break.
Yeah, that year break was actually not good for us.
Yeah, well, we had Mandalorian.
Yeah, no, that's true. All right, so if you guys like WandaVision, episodes 3 and 4, tell us in the comments down below. Like our videos. Follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Spotify. We have more episodes. We're going to continue reviewing this until the end. We're gonna do another topic too. Yeah. If you can't tell by Mike's attire, if you're watching the video. So yeah, from the top of the dome
to the back of the pack,
we are
the Top Back Podcast.
Peace.
Peace.